Oh, hi, this is the analysis of Nathaniel. A little video here now about I'm talking about Mercenaries 2. Now, Mercenaries 2, again, a game I talked about, a month ago, like on my channel. And for this is mainly about factions, so I'm going deep into the factions and the game. Third person action adventure, right? So yeah, so it's kind of like this. It's a third person action adventure, open world type game. We're in Venezuela. Yeah, and it has many different factions in it. If you guys are watching this, please subscribe, share the video, please share, like, a comment down below for feedback, please. So, anyways, now Venezuela. So, I'm playing the game. There's many different factions. So there's the Venezuelan army. That's the evil faction. Universal Petroleum, American private army, which is kind of like they gather oil or something like that. They're like an oil company. The PLAV, they're kind of like the guerrilla forces in Venezuela, so they're the so they rebel against the Venezuelan army. You got the pirates, you got allied nations, and you got China. Allied nations basically are the US army. So playing the game, like when you play the game, you get to go through go between the different factions, and it's really fun. Really, it's really certain factions are they gonna hate other factions, right? So obviously, the PLAV, they hate Universal Petroleum, right? So Universal Petroleum, they like this basically. So yeah, so the PLAV, they basically hate them. Yeah, you have other scenarios where everybody hates Venezuelan army, even though it's their country, where everybody hates them. Now they're like the main enemy in the game. Pirates, basically, like everybody hates them except China, I believe. So yeah. It's weird, it's weird. So yeah, you have all these different factions, and let's say if you there's an option in the game, allied nations and China, they're like the two biggest militaries in the game, America and China. And then there's an option like in the campaign where you can either choose to be China or America. So it's really fun. It's but if you choose to side with China or whatever, but by the second mission, you can't be friends with the allied nations because you're going to be taking out their high value targets and all that. So yeah, it's a lot of that, but going through it too, like I can either choose, like do you want to be there's different there's obviously going to be different advantages, right? So China, for example, China gives you China has probably like the most variety of tanks, right? Obviously, third person, open world. You go in tanks, helicopters, attack helicopters. China has the most variety of helicopters, tanks, attack helicopter APCs. America probably has the most variety of airstrikes. So the game, you can call down airstrikes in the game. So, like if you go deep into the American faction, contracts, like you're a mercenary, you take on their contracts. You unlock things like a carpet bomb or a certain type of satellite missiles and all that. So yeah, and the grill, the pirates, they basically, if you team up, like if you go like with the pirates, they basically give you like jet skis or whatever. It is minor, it's very minor. And at the PLAV, no, the Universal Petroleum will give you a certain type of, I believe a certain type of oil capacity upgrade, where you basically are collecting fuel throughout the world. And there's a limited capacity, so the Universal Petroleum will give you like a certain bonus, capacity. So yeah, so you can obviously be friends with many of them, except at Universal Petroleum. Venezuelan army, they're neutrally bad always, so they're always your enemy in the game. So like it's really interesting about it too is that the allied nations, no, another thing too, like okay, let's say like if you're between these two, right? You can take on a contract where, or there's throughout the world, there's these kind of there's light blue triangles, and they have checks in them, or they'll have like some sort of target in them symbol, and then so it's basically the check is basically like a high value target you can capture or kill them. So it's really interesting though. Universal Petroleum will have like a high value target, so we'll target someone from the guerrilla army, and then. When that happens, you gotta. If you choose to side with the Universal Petroleum, And then I decide to piss off at the PLAV. A trust meter goes on. So the trust meter goes down where is a faction going to be hostile towards you or neutral? Or you know, vice versa. The PLAV may have a contract or a certain thing where you gotta go and blow up certain universal petroleum buildings. So yeah. And then I lose trust there. So yeah, it's really all about kind of, you know, seeing what happens like if you're an enemy like with this faction, and then if you're an enemy though like with any of these factions, there's red zones on the map and you can't go in, there's no trespassing, you're not allowed there in their zones, they'll shoot you on sight. So yeah, they're hostile towards you. No, it's different to you know, look up my culture video games. Universal Petroleum, they're I could tell they're very rich. They are, you know, obviously oil rich. Private army, so they have they live in this tall ass building, right? This huge skyscraper, and they have like a state of the art. They have kind of like these state of the art trucks and tanks and all that. And whereas the PLAV, Rebel Army, they have more, you know, I could tell it's kind of rusted up vehicles, Humvees, old tanks, and all that they scavenge from the Venezuelan army. So yeah, China obviously, and then China, America, they're basically like a full-on military. They have military bases, camps, and all that, and tanks all over the place, attack helicopters all over their, you know, areas, you know. So yeah, and the pirates are basically, I don't know what they were trying to depict them as. I guess it's some sort of a Caribbean pirates, I think, but something like that. But yeah, and the pirates, they live like in islands throughout the map. They live in islands where they have these big huts or whatever, and then they go on jet skis or whatever, or they'll have their own attack helicopter. So there's all these different cultural, you know, not really cultural, but they have different type of, I can really see the difference between the factions, you know. Mainly, like what stands out is the Universal Petroleum and the PLAV, you know. But the rest really is just military base. It's very military base. Again, like what I said, China has like so many variety of tanks, APCs, attack helicopters. America has, like if you're able to shop, like you shop, you go in certain faction areas and you can shop for, obviously I can call it airstrikes, right? That's what makes the game like really fun. And then America probably has the most variety of missile attack, of different type of missiles, you know. That's pretty fun, you know. So again, that being said, now there is a trophy. If you're playing on PS3, I know the game is a PS3, right? There's a trophy where if you piss everybody off, let's say if I piss everybody off, you can piss off every faction in the game. And I basically get, you know, like it's a trophy. It's like everybody hates Matthias, something like that. It's a trophy. Matthias is the guy that you play as. So yeah, it's very... I like that type of trophy, but it can be hard because if you blow up a certain enemy base, no, a certain faction base or whatever, other factions will like you more, and the opposing faction will like you more. So you really gotta, you know. I remember there's one mission where, no, spoilers, China is a mandatory mission where China asks you to blow up at Universal Petroleum's headquarters. So that huge building that they have this huge ass building, right? So Universal Petroleum, that's it right there. You basically blow it up, and it's really cool. It's actually pretty cool in that blowing it up, I can blow it up like with some airstrike, and then you see like an explosion, like the whole foundation beneath it, there's smoke all over the place, fire and all that. So yeah, not if you decide to go with China. So yeah, you know, I can just show you here. That's one of the military. Yeah, so that's Venezuelan army. That's the Venezuelan army. Are you gonna see them a lot throughout the game because they're the main enemy, right? You're gonna kill them the most. So you can't be friends with them. You cannot be. The PLAV again. Can kind of go down here. That's them. See, they live in. They basically live in jungle areas, you know, and jungles and old like old buildings and all that, you know. There's barbed wire, and then you have Allied Nations, a China is probably my favorite like faction in terms of, because they have so much like power, you know? Yeah. So, and it all takes place within Venezuela. Venezuela being a very oil-rich company country. So I like the way how the game portrayed that though. You have all these different, you have, you know, are the two big foreign nations, China and America, coming to seize the oil from the evil dictator in the game, and it's something like that. But it's really like every man, every faction in for himself, you know. Now I play in the game, you know, if I've you know, since Universal Petroleum is basically America, they're friends automatically like with the allied nations. So you know, like both of these factions are very close. There's other things where China supplies the PLAV, so they supply them with military and all that, and tanks and certain type of attack vehicles and helicopters. So if you piss off, I believe you piss off, there's something where if you piss off the PLAV, you also piss off China as well. But China doesn't come into the game until after. These four, they're in the game early, but they don't come into the game until after. It's a pretty quick campaign. So yeah, factions, video game factions, it's very interesting. I don't see this in games much. Need to utilize this, but man, you know, and again, Mercenaries 2, I highly recommend it if you haven't played it. Please like, subscribe, share the video. Please, again, subscribe while I'm pressing it down here. Have you guys played Mercenaries 2? Let me know. Have you guys played it? Are you planning on playing it? Thank you.